producing bits from everywhere.
I've got to switch my tracker on.
Oh,
there's the house keys.
I'll get these tiles in for a bit.
Hey,
looking good.
Feeling the love.
I tell you,
it's things like this.
Yeah. Because we started off with there were six of us out of Keswick.
Yeah.
And four vessels.
Like
Charming. £20 donation, £10 donation, £10 donation, £20 donation. Superb. It's like,
what's
this
going
is
on? So
exactly.
And it's like 20 quid.
This is what I wanted.
Yeah.
No.
Thank you.
what should I be? Is this the fate that half of the world's planned for me?
I don't want to go running now. Never mind after that breakfast. I don't want to go running now. I have bitten off. I have bitten off more than I can chew.
Believers,
all of sinners the same. Girl, you now die. Believers bound to the tracks of the train. I'm not excited, but should I be? Is this the fate that half of the world's planned for me? I know I love you, and you love to see. But what only water contains a little drop for me.
Here they come.
I'm not excited, but should I be? Is this the fate that half of the world's planned for me? I know I love you, and you love to see.
The thing is, I want to try and get a happy handshake. Yep. Come on. Cheers, buddy.
Really, really good.
Very good.
I've learned an awful lot just in that one ride.
Right. See you soon, mate.
Cheers.
Yeah.
I've been thinking since Hard Knot, everything was going really well until Hard Knot, and then Rhinos just started to fall back behind schedule. Ambleside a little bit behind, but then it's a schedule I kind of made up anyway. And then you start thinking, actually, I've got another thing to do. I'm looking for £50,000 minimum, and basically what happened was there was an avalanche that was caused by the earthquake, and it took out our base camp on Everest, and we lost three members of staff, and they between them have left behind nine children, and one of them his house fell down as well. So, you know, it's just a huge amount of turmoil and upheaval for those families. And what you find in Nepal is that there isn't any social security, there isn't child benefit, there aren't free school places. The mothers probably haven't got careers either. So what I want to do is put six children who are of school age through their schooling. And on average, that's going to be about 10 years each. And when you multiply the figures, it comes to about £50,000. Ideally, I'd like to get more than that, so that then I can fill some money out into the local economy as well. Because there are other people who were sort of involved in or were affected in various ways, whether it be that they can no longer work because of an injury, or again, houses damaged, personal possessions being lost. So, you know, ideally, I'm looking at 100,000, but for the time being, 50,000 for the schooling.
Fucked it, friend, it's on its head, it struck the street.
That was the SIS again, please.
Nice one, fella.
Oh dear.
Doing well there. How's it going?
Hi. It's going.
Alright, yes.
It's a special place, this, eh? Look at these clouds behind you. Awesome.
Not a wish for a better morning to do this.
Yeah.
Another leg like that, Tim.
Yeah.
You're going to be walking up that beach there. Yeah, really good. Nice. Am I in the right spot? Can you see us all the time?
Or? Absolutely, yeah. Perfect.
Are you wanting something to eat?
I think I'll have a big eat at the jetty.
Okay. Well, that's, you know, you're belting it out here, mate. That's like 45, 50 minutes tops.
Yeah.
45 minutes, really. Come get up.
Cheers, buddy.
Just get it. That's fine. Sounding good, Tim.
Oh, it's not the... we're not going to the Lodore, are we? We're going to the red...
Yes, that red patch, that's the jetty there.
Yep, cool, perfect. Race you.
Okay.
First one there buys breakfast.
Yeah. Oh, hang on. Cramp again.
Okay.
Where we are.
the holy bread.
I think your breakfast is ready now, so looking good.
The local economy really depends on trekking and mountaineering and tourism, and the season doesn't really start until October, November, so that will be about, what, 6 months since the first earthquake. It's still another 2 or 3 months from now. I'd like to think that the danger is probably over and that it is safe to go back. And although there's money coming in from international aid and there's lots of NGOs doing their bit, that money isn't going to necessarily filter down to the local economy. And you know, when a trekker buys a can of Coke or a trekker buys a meal in a tea house, then that is going directly not only to the tea house owner but also to the porter that supplied the tea house and the cook that works in the tea house, etc., etc. So, you know, I think if we can get people backtracking, that's got to be a good thing for, you know, the local economy and the country as a whole.
And the days are cold and the cards all fold and the saints we see are all made of gold. When your dreams all fail and the wrongs we hail are the worst of all and the bloods run stale. I wanna hide the truth, I wanna shelter you, but with the beast inside, there's nowhere we can hide. No matter what we breed, we still are made of greed. This is my kingdom come, this is my kingdom come. Sinners crawl, so they dug your grave in the masquerade. We'll come calling out at the mess you've made. Don't wanna let you down, but I am hellbound. Oh, this is all for you. Don't wanna hide the truth. No matter what we breed, we still are made of greed. This is my kingdom come, this is my kingdom come. You
I'm feeling the love, you know? Pikes, and we're heading over to Rossett Pike. We're gonna get wet feet. We've already got wet feet, actually. We're gonna get wetter feet.
I had to sleep on the way. I had to lie down and have a power nap. They call it a power nap. I was just asleep.
Going up. It was good. It was dark. Quite windy. Cold. Not many people. Great views. Got him here. He's working strong, so it's worked out well. Probably took a bit longer than we thought, but that's not a problem. Got him round. super tough night. It's very wet, very boggy, very dark. Tim had a couple of low points, just pulled himself together, and he's going super strong now. He's had a couple of power naps, seems really, really, really well sorted.
Absolute magic. Hey, that man's got guts. He's still sane and he's still going well. You know, he'll get to Keswick all right. We know we've got a big storm coming in, but he's prepared for that, mentally and physically. He's going well and he looks good, you know, for what he's doing. And he must have prepared himself well for this outing. He's grown up real better now. Doing a great job supporting Tim, and without backup we just can't do these things anyway.
My legs are really good.
Miles, 11 and a half hours, so yeah, quite an epic ride. Fantastic riding through the night, Tim was really strong. Finished at 5:30 in the morning.
Bust my ankle.
Alright, yeah.
Tender. Oh, he wants to get me far up, but they do need to get me.
Ten miles.
About that.
All downhill.
Apart from the three hills.
Yeah. It might be a little bit tough.
Right.
Killing me, stare, skies of blue. The signs you wear are making me so confused. But the mountains and the trees, are they just what you need, or are they less than what you'd expect to see? And if you're leaving, we'll keep.
Hi!
And sorry, I blinked.
Come on, back it up.
Come on.
No, I'm too tired.
Come on. And action.
That was nice, a lot of
You've been anywhere, nice?
I've had a weekend.
Oh, have you?
It's been a hard weekend.
Fantastic, but I couldn't have done it without obviously Ali's help, but all the people taken part. I'm a bit relieved that I've made it round and I'm in one piece and it's all gone really well. And I've just sort of said to these people here, I couldn't have done it without the support of everyone, whether it be a driver, a runner, someone paddling alongside, someone just even being by the side of the road and saying, well done, man, and let me go past. It's just been fun. I wouldn't change anything apart from leg three of the bob, but I wouldn't change anything. It's been brilliant.
So, you know, the fundraising has been happening before, it's happening during the event, and it's still going to happen after. What I don't want to do is have enough money to put the kids through school for 3 years and then run out. You know, that would be worse than useless. That would be worse than even starting funding these children. So, yes, I'd like money to still keep coming in. I've got a page on Just Giving, or you can contact the charity directly, Supporting Nepal's Children. You'll see on their website the fantastic work that they do. I was actually on the mountain the day that it happened, and we had left base camp only a few hours before, and it was quite snowy, so we didn't really see anything happening. But what we did sense was a sort of movement and Serac fall and avalanches around. Initially, I thought it was just quite localized to us, but then when we sort of got communication with other people on the mountain and with base camp, we realized that it was a much bigger deal, and that base camp had been affected and that we'd lost three members of staff. But then we heard that Nepal wide it was a big problem, so it sort of made our problem diminish in some way compared with the enormity of the whole issue. But then you've still got to deal with your own situation. So that then came back to us dealing with our situation, which was basically staying on the mountain for a couple of nights at Camp 1, making sure that my clients were safe, the Sherpa that was with us was safe, and then we got back down to base camp and started trying to pick up the pieces. Yeah. I think really I'd say that it's very humbling being in their presence. They were all individual characters in their own right. So Pasang Temba was the cook at Camp 2 and had cooked at Camp 2 on Everest, which is 6,400 metres for I think 19 years on the trot, which is just, oh, you know, ultra hard work, really, really harsh environment, cold, altitude to deal with. You know, he was constantly boiling water, melting ice, boiling water, cooking meals, and you know, we couldn't be there without a person like that. He was such a hardy soul, but such a lovely character. Kumar was a guy who kind of lent his hand to anything, really. So he would be one day herding yaks and another day helping in the kitchen. Next day he'd be, yeah, melting water on Ahmed Ablam for my clients on that expedition. And just very smiley, very gentle. Tenzing was new to the team, so I'd only known him 2 years, but a kind of guy that you instantly took a like to. Great sense of humour, very bubbly character. But I think the thing that sums up for all three of them is that we couldn't do our job without them, and it's very humbling being in their presence. They are just such solid people who give so much, even though they haven't actually got any, you know, sort of worth to give. You know, they just give in emotion, or they give in support, or they help in other ways.
Imagine there's no heaven. It's easy if you try. And no hell below us. And above us is only sky. Imagine all the people living for today. You may say that I'm a dreamer, but I'm not the only one. I hope someday you'll join us. Is one. Imagine there's no countries. It isn't hard to do. Nothing.